I've been asked to talk about the terms used for these media, and of course there are so many. There's alternative media, community media, and in some ways those are similar because they look at the everyday processes of how communities and people on the ground try to construct their lives, communicate with each other, and construct an ongoing life with each other in dialogue. And that's fine. And then there's terms like radical media and counter-information media. And those focus more on media, grassroots media, that challenge the status quo, that explicitly contest the political and economic structures that we live under. And then there's a medium term, if you like Clemencia Rodriguez's citizens media, which moves away from looking at the power of media at some national level or international level and focuses much more on media that citizens themselves produce and empower themselves. And the notion of empowerment through media is really central to her notion, getting away from the notion of power as something that only operates in governments and in big corporations. For myself, I tend to prefer at the moment the term social movement media because I think it draws attention to the connection between these communication technologies and humans and human interactions and human networks. But in the final analysis, why there are so many terms is because these kinds of media are far more diverse and far more interesting in many ways than mainstream media. Mainstream media are quite complicated too, but it's pretty obvious. You talk about the mainstream press, you talk about mainstream television or cinema, the internet, everybody knows what these are. When you talk about the media we focus on, then my goodness, you have such a huge, rich variety. And of course, therefore, you're going to have a lot of different terms. So pick your term to choose your focus.